Hello, my name is Wade Nemer, and this is Rotary Serving Our Community. One of the things I'm involved with is the Rotary Rose Parade Float Committee. It's one of those great little groups that I get to work with. The interesting thing about the float, this Rotary float, is that it's put together on private donations. In other words, Rotary International does not support this. It is done by the committee itself and by people that contribute or donate to the cause. This float is actually seen by over 70 million people internationally on television, and there's about 700 to 750,000 people along the parade route in Pasadena. This is on the 1st of January each year. The parade goes down, and we are one of, generally speaking, about 20 to 30 floats in that parade. I brought some pictures with you I want to jump right into because I've got a lot of things to share with you. A lot of you are interested in, well, what's the parade and, you know, what's the float and what does it do? So I wanted to show you actually some of the background of what these floats actually go through. The first picture I have is a picture showing the float in process. Now, we start this float project at the beginning of each year in the design concept, but the actual construction and the decorating of the colors itself occurs the full week, full month of December. And this is a picture here of the float actually getting ready. You can see it's a crocodile. The theme this year was crocodile, Rotary Rocks, and the music was from Elton John's Crocodile Rock. So, of course, that was pretty fitting. The next picture I have is a picture showing some of the people. These are some of the decorators. Each one of the decorators gets a shirt and spends about 8 hours working on the float itself. This is some of the pre-work, and as you see, it's very tedious. These people here are actually getting the float flowers ready to decorate onto the float itself. Now, it takes about 800 to 1,000 hours itself to actually do the decorating on the float. As you get closer to the end, that's when the actual live flowers go on, flowers, vegetables, fruit, whatever, the perishables. And so the last week, right after Christmas, we jump right all over the float and actually start decorating it at that time. One of the features that we have is that every year, the international president actually comes in and sits on the float and is one of the riders. This has occurred for the last 40 years. The presidents have been riding it since the year 2011. So it's one of those fascinating things. So the picture I have here is President Barry Rasmussen and his wife Esther actually coming in to decorate that float. Now, Barry's a pretty tall guy, so we gave him the job of actually sticking that on. We told him that if that were to fall off, we would be docked points for that, but at least if it does occur during the parade route, it's going to be on the opposite side of the camera. So that's him. His wife, Esther, as you can see, was one of the proud supporters of his efforts. The next picture we have is a picture of the two of them putting on some of the vegetables, I would say. These are some vegetables that were actually set in, put in place by them, and it's actually designed by the float manufacturer to have specific things go in specific areas. The next picture I have is the parade route. This parade route actually goes about 5.5 miles, so it's a long one. It starts at the beginning where the parade floats are actually staged in. All the floats are staged into one area, and then it goes down into the beginning of the float, the parade itself, and I'll show you some pictures of that later. But it is quite a grueling excursion for these poor walkers and riders because they're there for 3 to 4 hours. The next picture I have is a picture of President Barry decorating a float. And interesting, we have four presidents, international presidents, that come together. The Lions, the Kiwanis, and the Optimus presidents meet with us in Rotary. However, the Optimus have yet to put a float in. So this is the president of Rotary Optimus International actually helping us out with the float. She brought her family, which was a lot of fun, and she enjoyed doing it. Hopefully, we'll have more participation and possibly even a partnership with Optimus in the future on these floats. The next picture is of the two presidents, President of Rotary and President Optimus, getting together. Again, a very good time. We meet on a number of occasions with the different presidents, but this is a picture of them, the two of them, coming together for decorating the float, and we have the Optimus help us out each and every year. The next picture we have is a picture of the international presidents. This is a president summit. I'll do a program on this one, an actual show on that that will talk to you about it. But we have the president of Kiwanis, the president of Lions, of Optimus, and Rotary, which we actually host and sponsor what we call the Rotary International Pres- I'm sorry, the President International Summit, where all the international presidents come together, and we actually host an event for them. It's a brunch that we hold each and every year. The next picture I have is a picture showing some of the sponsorships. Now, in order for this float to actually occur, we have to have the adjacent districts and district governors gain support of that. So we have actual six districts and district governors that come together to help fund this. Now, the float itself is about a $180,000 project, and it is up to us to help fundraise this. Majority of the efforts come from this group right here that you see. These are the sitting governors of Southern California and Arizona and Nevada area, and they come together each year to support our efforts with the float. And this is them getting together. We have a special luncheon with them, along with the president each year that comes in and greets them and thanks them for that. The next picture we have is a picture, because so far you've only seen the governors. This is the family and spouses of that group also, along with the committee that helps out each and every year. The picture shows some of the staffers that we have. When I say staffers, those people on our committee, the board of directors that make this all possible. There's a number of them. I see Walt in this picture, and I see Ray in the picture. Frank should be there someplace. I guess he's actually taking the picture, but this is the group that we actually use together to come through each year to organize this float and its efforts. The next picture I have is a picture during one of the evening dinners. This dinner occurs on the 30th of December. This one did. Each year is usually about the 30th of December. But we invite our committee members, along with the adjacent district people, district governors, and their staff to come in and enjoy it. The picture that you see here is actually a picture of the riders. It's a before picture, as you can see, because if it was after, they'd be looking a little more tired. It's fairly grueling, but these people are there. They support themselves by actually fundraising to get spots as walkers or riders. To be a walker, we ask $6,000 per walker to as a contribution to the float. For those that ride, it is a $10,000 seat actually to do that. And so, again, it helps quite a bit with our fundraising. For a lot of people, this is, quote, their bucket list. They do a lot of fundraising in order to do this. Some of them were governors. The governors asked their members to help support them in their efforts so they could pass the word along of Rotary. And believe it or not, this is the largest public image campaign that Rotary does. And it's all privately funded, because there's very few items in Rotary where we could reach a 70 million person audience. The next picture I have is a picture of the walkers and riders during judging day. And this is kind of neat, because during judging day, we all come together, we have a specific time set in place, and these walkers have to come actually in the uniform or the clothes that they're going to wear down the parade route. It's a very strict judging, and this is where it is decided whether or not we are going to get an award or not. This group here, as you see, their theme decided to go with the nice Bahamian theme. So Rotary Rocks is the theme, and you can see that they took it to the extreme with what they decided to wear. The costumes, thanks to Maureen, were put together by that. The next picture we have shows some of the details of the float. And I put these in there because it is amazing. We are scored based on complete coverage of the float. In other words, every square inch of that float has to be covered with an organic material. If it is not, we get docked points for that. So I did a little bit of detail pictures here for you. This one shows the front of the float. The next picture goes into a little bit more detail, showing how these flowers actually become attached to the float and how it works. As you can see, the service, the riding part, all covered by berries. Every inch of that, including the part behind it, the crocodile skin, is all covered with organic matter, as is everything else. So it's pretty fascinating how we do it. The next picture I took was a picture during judging time. I wanted to show you this because it's not always that the presidents have a good time, but Barry had a great time there. This is him and his wife Esther enjoying it, knowing that they're going to be cruising down the parade route during the 1st of January. About 5 hours they're going to be sitting in that spot. So it was nice to see them enjoying it for a little bit of time that they were there. The next picture shows a picture a little bit of distance preparing for that judging portion of it. This is actually staged in. The judges there are there currently. There's a bell that rings the minute judging starts. The music goes. The people become entertainers at that point in time and will replicate what is going to happen down the parade route. The judging takes about 2 to 3 minutes, closer to 3 minutes time, and the judges are changed each and every year, so we don't always get judged on the same thing. So I wanted to put this picture in there because this is before. The next picture shows the during, where we actually have the judges walking through. And the judges have assistants with them. They score and they mark specific items specific to each and every float, and they judge all of the floats. The float right next to us was actually the Lions float. So those are the Lions people. They will be judged immediately following us. So when the bell rings, our walkers and riders are pretending like they're actually on the parade route. The music's going. And when I say music going, Elton John, you know, Crocodile Rock must have been quite the hit, because at the next picture, the same judge decided to give us a little heel kick. She actually started dancing to the music. Judges usually are pretty placid. In other words, they do not display any type of emotions, but at this point in time, she definitely enjoyed it. She was dancing to the music as she was judging that. At the finish of the judging, then a bell is rung again, indicating that the judging has been completed. So that's kind of the judging part of it. Many of you are wondering, well, how do we end up getting awards or not getting awards? Well, this is a portion of the judging itself. And so it's pretty fascinating how they do that. The next pictures I have, a little bit more details. So we have pictures of the float itself on display, and you can see how intricate these designs all were. Here we go with some vegetables and some leaves that were actually adhered with glue to the float itself. This is the finished product. The next picture shows the tail, and the tail shows again how the detailing goes. And this is when all the scaffolding is out of the way, judging has occurred, and again, the finished product. We take a full month to put this together. The next picture is a picture of the actual float company builders themselves. These are the Lutz houses. Chris is actually the one that we work with. And his job is to make sure that all these floats get down. It's a $10,000 fine if the floats do not make it. His wife is the one that actually designs the floats. So she's right there next to us. And she designs not only the floats themselves, the color renderings, but also what goes on to the specific colors that are being displayed. We have a picture. Next picture shows a picture of the Lions president and of our president, Barry. The two of them were, believe it or not, we were back to back. So the Lions president sat on the float behind us. Barry was on the float right in front. Next picture we have is a picture of Barry actually during a radio interview. So there's quite a bit of media. We have four major TV stations from the Los Angeles area come through. They'll film and do interviews. Radio does the same exact thing. And so it's a pretty good display of what Rotary does. And this is before the parade even starts. We start in the morning, 3:30 in the morning. Barry, again, is from the Bahamas, and he froze. It was 39 degrees, actually 37 degrees when we started. He says anything below 80 degrees is freezing for him. So poor guy was quite the good sport getting out there with that clothes on to actually do the parade route. The next picture I have is a picture of even the spectators, and people know it's a Rotary float. So as they walk down, they go, hey, this is the Rotary float. We have Rotarians, non-Rotarians, people from audience come through, and they will actually take pictures, selfies, whatever, to get into the picture and become part of the actual parade atmosphere itself. So I thought that was pretty fascinating. The next picture we have is a picture of the socks. We actually, Barry did not get the memo that he needed to have white shoes, so he took them to go buy shoes. But one of the people on our committee found these flamingo socks, and so I fired that up because this year, one of the cover shots of the magazine, the Rotarian magazine, showed a group of flamingos with one flamingo looking in the opposite direction. All the rest of the flock was looking the other way. And Barry made a point of that. He said that the flamingo looking the wrong way is the flamingo of most interest because there is a flamingo looking for change. And so because of that, very fitting that we found a pair of socks for him that he was game enough to wear during the parade route. So Sorry, Barry, but this picture is going to become famous for you. The next picture we have is a picture showing the group right before it's ready to roll. So as you can see, the tape is still in place. That float was staged in at 1 o'clock in the morning. The float drivers underneath, and we'll talk about that in another program, but they actually had to stay with the float that whole time. It was driven in from Irwindale to Pasadena. So this is that group. The next picture was actually the start of the parade itself. It's fascinating. There's a stealth bomber that actually comes down the Colorado Boulevard to start the parade, and it is quite the spectacle. This thing comes in there, rips down the parade route, makes a turn, and from what I understand, hits the afterburners, and literally within seconds or minutes is over Arizona. So again, a lot of fun to see that happening. Next picture I have is a picture of us getting started. This is the actual very beginning of the parade. You can see people are very energetic, ready to go. I put this picture up there because our governor, Sandy, is the one that's seated there. She bought one of the big seats, so I wanted to make sure that she got a little bit of airtime on this on the show, so that's her right there. The next picture we have is a picture of the float coming down Colorado Boulevard, and this is usually where I stage in to get photos. We drop the riders off 5 o'clock in the morning. From there, we get them to the edge of the parade start. Once the parade starts, my crew and myself run down probably about a mile and a half to that place to take the pictures. Once we get the shots, we run back up to the vans where we staged in the riders, have to jump in the vans and drive to the very end of the parade route, 6 miles away. Takes a little time, a little bit of effort, and a lot of coordination. So we do all of the rushing to get to the end of the parade route. At that point in time, we usually end up sitting for about an hour waiting for them to come in. But that's kind of the deal, and that's the way it works. The last picture that I have here is a picture of the group completed. You see a lot of happy faces, not quite the energy that you saw at the beginning of the parade route, but 5.5 miles, 6 miles later. And by the way, some of them are substantially relieved. It's 4 hours on that parade route with no bathroom breaks. So with that, that's kind of how it works out. And this is the way it went. These people, some of them end up coming back the following year. They will re-sponsor themselves for that. But it's a lot of fun. It's pretty interesting how it goes. With that, I actually have some footage that I wanted to share with you. And so I'm going to jump into that. I have some interviews, give you a little atmosphere of what the actual parade route's like. I have live music and actual shots from the parade route itself. So please enjoy the video.
We can do my maraca.
We are now going, guys.
Maraca.
We have Mike. You can sing for us.
Oh. I thought we were just
singing. Excited about this parade thing.
A little bit.
This is how we keep warm.
Yeah, this is kind of cold out here.
It is.
It looks warm in the video, so you guys will have to tell us how cold it really is.
Oh, we're so warm. The sun is just beating down.
There you go.
7 degrees.
Oh, it's getting warmer.
There you go. Okay, thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that video. Again, it shows some of the excitement that actually occurs during the float itself, and it's actually quite fascinating. I had the opportunity to go up at the top where Orange Grove makes a turn onto Colorado Boulevard, and I can tell you that look, what it looks like starting down that hill, is breathtaking. You look down and you can see the road going for as far as you can see with line on both sides of spectators. Again, 700 to 750,000 people will be looking at that float. So as they go down, again, it's very breathtaking to actually see and experience. Each year we do this and we try and get between 12 and 14 people, as many as 16 involved with that. The committee actually starts meeting for this as of January. So the first Wednesday of each month, we actually get together with this committee. So we are starting now the next year's plan for floats. This coming year, the year 2020, I will be chairing this committee, and my job is to not only coordinate a good float to get it out there, but also to make sure that we have the money to get this going. And so because of that, it puts a lot of time and a lot of effort. We meet once a month. If any of you are interested, I will give you the information at the end of the show. But it's something that's quite fascinating. I think a lot of you will enjoy. Many Rotarians from around the world actually do not even know that this event occurs. And because of that, this coming year, I have worked with a lot of the international magazines, and 27 of the international Rotary magazines will now be covering this in their magazines. It'll have articles, everything from the International President's Summit all the way down to the float development itself. I will be doing phase work on each and every one of these, showing the plans, the way it's going to be done, the design itself, all the way into the construction, from the metal skeleton to the foaming to the coloring to the test riding to they actually have to have a fire check where the fire marshal comes in and you have to evacuate that float in 45 seconds or you can't run it down the parade route, to the very last part in December where we actually do the decorating of that. So it is actually very fascinating, a fascinating experience. And if you ever have a chance to see these live, they are spectacular. These floats are huge. Oftentimes you have no idea how big they actually are. Now, the float that we use, the company float that we use, the builder is Phoenix Float Builders, and they're based in Irwindale. And they have an actual warehouse where they build floats. That's their full-time job. They do floats all year long. So come February, March, we actually come and select a design. As of March, the actual construction starts. They will start building on a basic chassis, a tractor chassis, the metalwork that's going to be used to sculpture the float itself. From there, it is then they put screen mesh on it, then they put foam on, and that foam actually acts as a supporting structure for the float itself and also for the flowers. Pretty fascinating. The other thing that I was looking at this year, because we struggle so much each and every year financially, was to see about actually looking at those cooperating organizations with Rotary, because this float literally sends a message of what Rotary does. We script a dialogue that is given to all of the media that cover this float. And this media pack includes talking points specifically to the float itself, but also on what Rotary does. And so that becomes an important part of that. So I was looking at the opportunity actually of partnering in with some of the organizations, some of the groups that support Rotary Foundation and our work on humanitarian efforts worldwide, and we'll be approaching them to hopefully, you'll see this coming year, 6 to 8 of our international partners with their names, their people on the float itself. This year's theme is Rotary Connects the World. The president, incoming president, Mark Maloney, a good friend of mine from Alabama, will be riding the float with his wife this year again, and I think it's going to be another good one. The idea of the float and the idea of us being Rotary Connects the World is one of those things where we can use a lot, because this will be the very first float that we will be putting out that will be reaching out to the international audience of Rotary. So the 27 regional magazines cover the entire Rotary world. So between them and the Rotarian magazine itself, we should be covered quite well on those efforts and people being more aware of what we do. Now think about this. The float costs $180,000 to $200,000, but we get literally a viewership and time of 1 to 2 minutes that goes internationally on television each year. It's replayed again and replayed throughout the year, actually, so people will see our message. I think one of the good things, and one of the reasons why I stay involved with this float, is because of the friendships that we create. There are people all over the world that see this float. And because of that, the larger the audience becomes, the more connection we have with Rotary, the easier it is for us to get the message out. This year, we'll be using the Rotary theme. That would be Rotary Connects the World. You'll see an international flair of itself of how we are impacting the world through world fellowship, friendship, and family that we have in Rotary. So with that, I wanted to share this with you. The website, and I'm going to have it posted down below, is rotaryfloat.org. If you go there, you could actually see and get the experience of how the float looks from the very beginning all the way through to the end. All of our information will be there. We will be upgrading and updating that website each and every week. You'll get something new in that, along with the progress of how the float is going to be built. Next year, I'll actually have another show on how the float went from very beginning to very end. And again, rotaryfloat.org, take a look at that one, because if you're willing to contribute, if you want to help us out with our efforts, if you want to participate, if you want to be a walker or rider, or if you want to meet the international president during the holiday season, spend some time with us, you're welcome to. You're invited to do that. And with that, thank you very much, and we will see you next time.